Hey folks, how you doing there? Coming to you today on Thursday, September 8th. I think it's enough tomfoolery playing around with various videos and talking about, like, you know, space agencies and whatnot, but I'm just having fun with stuff sometimes. I sometimes see a video and I just go, you know what? That's funny. I'm playing with that. I'll tell you what's not funny is going shopping to Walmart and finding something like this. That's right, one of these guys. The emergency... Hang on a sec. Let's put full weight on this thing. 10 ounces of Swiss Army steel. Yeah. That's the sound effect. Like a brick. Now, when you eat it, is it still like a brick? Remains to be seen. I did do a segment on the podcast where I was talking about this item. These are available. This one got dropped, obviously. That's why it's got the dent in the corner. So anyway, what this guy is right here is this is going to be a food bar. Emergency food bar from, of all people, they describe this as, what is this? The Ultimate Survival Technologies. No, it isn't. It's actually made by Mayday. The same guys that make the lifeboat rations, the same guys that have been making the survival bars, and all those things that have been around for quite a while, okay? These guys are usually... consistency-wise, very much like trying to eat sawdust. As a matter of fact, I was in the checkout line, and I put a couple of these guys down, because they're selling for $5 a piece, okay? In terms of pricing, meh. But they had them in stock at Walmart, so I decided to grab a few. One for the shelf, one for the actual video. So, case in point, one of these guys actually comprised. They say it's 2,400 calories. Now, it's 2,400 calories, and this thing weighs a pound, okay? Now, conservatively, you could say this thing is easier to transport. It's going to be way harder to mess up than an MRE. Yes, you poke the package. Yes, you get water in there. Yes, it's going to mess it up. Not good. But by and large, what these things are, is they're actually intended to keep you running and gunning. Now, it does say 2,400 calories. So, obviously, 6 servings, 400 calories. Calories from fat are 170. Total fat is 19 grams. Carbs are 51 carbs. So, that's actually 51 grams of carbs will actually keep you running and gunning pretty good. No cholesterol, 10 milligrams of sodium, so that's always good. 7 grams of protein, keeps you running and gunning. Now, it has a pretty good amount of vitamins, not a huge amount, okay? All the vitamins there are like 4%, 20% of iron, 10% of calcium. Those numbers are abysmal, okay? They will not keep you running and gunning, especially under high stress where you're just blowing through vitamin C, okay? You're going to need supplements, probably in any way, shape, and form. If you're basically doing a survival thing, carry a bottle of premium style all-in-one vitamins. So you don't have to worry about like 15 or 16 different vitamins. Have the daily supplements, okay? At the very least, under stress, you're going to be blowing through so many other things that are going to just really take you down because you're not eating wild, you know, plants and stuff unless you really know what you're doing, okay? Worst of times, you're blowing through calories. And you're also blowing through the vitamins and minerals and those, you know, enzymes and things that come from those things as precursors that are going to keep you healthier in bad times. Have some vitamins. This thing does not have enough vitamins, okay? From north to south, what it says is it is enriched wheat flour, niacin, reduced iron, thiamine, so, you know, vitamins, riboflavin, folic acid, which is not a bad thing, but it doesn't have much of it. Palm shortening, which is palm oil, not great, but okay. Cane sugar. Now, here's the part that sucks. If they got cane sugar in there, why did they feel the need to back it up with this? High fructose corn syrup. Why? Defatted soy flour. Why? It really didn't need to have happen. I think what they did was they used the defatted soy flour for some protein. It's also got cornstarch. It's also got, let's see what here. And some of this script is actually hard to read because it's like so bumpy and stuff. So it's got corn syrup. Defatted soy flour, I'll get one through another. Cornstarch, vitamins and minerals, vitamins and minerals mix, which is a whole bunch of different things. Natural and artificial flavors, calcium propionate to, you know, extend freshness, contains soy and wheat. Now, it does actually have a pull date of, it was made April 16, the pull date is April 21, so it's a 5-year shelf life. I would tend to think that this sucker is pretty much, if they did it right, it got a nitrogen flush and then got the air sucked out to make it vacuum packed. If it still has the integrity of being vacuum packed, you're good to go. There is no ingress of oxygen to make it oxidize and actually go rancid, bad, or anything else. It's actually put together pretty well. Now, I am not scared of lifeboat rations. As a matter of fact, there was a guy that was selling like firework stuff, you know, build your own kind of like, you know, fireworks, build your own kind of like, you know, rockets and what have you. And he was selling surplus lifeboat rations. Now, this one actually is a one by, oh geez, who made this guy? I don't know. It's a very generic one. It's actually got no manufacturer stamping on there. It's a Mylar bag, and it is like little biscuits as opposed to like a big block of stuff. But he was selling these things because what happens is every so often the lifeboats have to be recertified. They pull the stuff out that is intended to keep you running and gunning during the worst of times when you get booted off the boat. So it's still okay to eat. It's just not certified any longer by the Coast Guard because it has to be a five-year pull. That's a five-year pull. Conversely, there's also this one here. Now you can see, actually, it does actually have the boat on board. So they're saying, you know, same deal. This one's actually probably closer to that. But I think it is blocks that are actually individually wrapped. I don't know. I've never had one of these things open. They do say eat the ration, which consists of 18 units of highly concentrated food. Eat only when hungry. Not more than 6 units per 24 hours. Yeah, because you can't crap. Take only 1 unit at a time. Eat small pieces. Chew well. Save drinking water. Do not drink more than 1/2 liter every 24 hours. Never drink seawater. Not even mixed with drinking water. So, what they're saying here is essentially these things will keep you running and gunning. And there is every possible language you possibly can think of is where this thing is, you know, written up. I mean, there's French, there's Japanese, there's Greek, there's Chinese, there's Korean, there's Russian, and, you know, pretty much everybody is, there's Arabic. I mean, they're intended these things to pretty much keep everybody going in the worst of times, kind of like these guys, which are, well, from the worst of places, Walmart. All right, so I know you guys, you're probably going to be saying, so, dude, what's it like? Well, unfortunately for me, yes, I actually do happen to have one open. Now, breaking these things off, they are literally, listen. Oh, actually, I'm sorry. I had this one broken off already. All right. Let me cheat and break one. Oh man, this thing's going to go everywhere. Hang on. Listen. Yeah, that's probably what it's going to sound like as it comes flying out of your ass. Okay. Now, conversely, this thing is pretty much sawdust, okay? It is not physically appealing to behold, okay? It is, well, yeah, pieces are breaking off. And the flavor is apple cinnamon. Now, you guys know my true adoration and complete affection for high fructose corn syrup. But for you guys, yeah, I'll suck one down. Why? Because I'm just stupid like that. So, types and companions and those out in the ethers, I commend it to you. You know, apple cinnamon survival bar from hell. See in a few days when this thing comes flying out going, yeah, it's going to sound exactly like that in the dude bathroom. I commend it to you. When in a survival situation, always make sure you have coffee. All right, so here's the thing. Flavor-wise, these things are actually, they actually taste really good. There's a really serious apple, you know, very fresh Granny Smith kind of tart, sweet, good apple, bam. And the backside is the cinnamon. I'm not detecting like a weird chemical flavor or something like that. The part that kind of sucks, and this is where you're kind of doing the dog with the peanut butter thing, is, yeah. The closest approximation I can make to this thing texturally, it is like the most crumbly, super compressed cornbread you will ever, ever, ever eat. But it kind of has that dry, fatty kind of, you know, oil thing going on in the background. Now, the part that actually also kind of sucks is, it's like when you're the kid and you basically have no adults around, and you open up the container of, like, you know, hot chocolate mix, and you take a spoon, you kind of go, nobody's looking, ow, and you take a spoon of hot chocolate mix, and you're like, oh, that's so good, oh, hell, and it's like stuck all over your teeth. It's literally stuck all over your teeth, even missed, you know, washing it down with some Tigger juice, It is on like Donkey Kong, and you're working your tongue like crazy trying to get it out from your teeth. That's why this helps your hunger, is because you're trying for the next 15 minutes to get the crap out of your mouth from one bite. Worst case scenario, yes, you can. Let me find the one that's not open. Don't want that one. The worst case scenario, yes, you can survive on these things. Yes, they will keep you running and gunning. Would you choose to do so? No, these are last ditch. Oh crap, I need to eat something. Kind of an operation type of food. It is not like grabbing an MRE. Trust me on that one, folks. These are not MREs. That said, you can find them on the internet. You can find them on eBay. You can find them also in your Walmart, if you're lucky. And you can buy them up. They're about $5 a piece in Wally World. And I snapped up a couple just for, you know, fun and grins. I'm going to break up with this one, folks. Eat good, keep fingering. As always, you know it. You love it. Oh, man. Don't eat these things until you absolutely positively cannot stand the thought of eating some fresh zombie sushi. Eat the zombie sushi instead. Well, maybe. I don't know. It's a toss-up. Which one would you want to eat more? Zombie sushi or Block O stuff? They're both going to wind up as a Block O stuff. Ooh. All right, folks, I'm going to break up with this one. Eco Cape Centering is always, you know it, you love it. Oh. Survival food bar. Ooh. See you guys.